Welcome back. In this video, you will learn how you can approximate the solution of a system of differential equations with Euler's method. Here, you see the system of differential equations for the rainbow fish and the gourami population and the corresponding initial values. Finding exact solutions to these differential equations is not that easy, so we are going to approximate the solutions. But to be able to do this, we first must rewrite the system into another form, which includes vectors. So let us start with the differential equations. If you define the vector function x to be the vector containing the functions p and g, the derivative of this vector is defined as a vector with the derivatives of p and g. We know two equations for these two derivatives, the differential equations. So let us use these. On the right, you see a vector containing two functions of p, g, and time t. Because p and g are part of the vector function x, these two functions are also functions of x. You can write this in a general form by calling the first function f1 of t and x, and the second function f2 of t and x. Because both functions depend on t and x, we can now even define a vector function f of t and x, which has as first component the function f1, and as a second component the function f2, like this. So what have we got now? We have that the derivative of the vector function x is equal to a vector function f of time t and x. Any system of differential equations can be written like this, as a differential equation for a vector function. As before, to find solutions or approximations to this differential equation, we also need an initial value for the function x. Can you think of one? In the exercises after this video, you can give your answer. In the remainder of this video, we are going to use this general form and formulate Euler's method for vector differential equations. Before you do this, let us repeat Euler's method for a differential equation for a scalar function y of time t. The first step of Euler's method for the function y of t is given as y at delta t is approximately y at 0 plus delta t times the right-hand function at t 0 and y at 0. So how can we use this for our vector differential equation? Let us just try something and calculate x after one time step of size delta t. The definition of x gives that this is a vector containing p and g at time delta t. But for these two values, we know an approximation if we use Euler's method. Using these approximations, you get this, where I use the two functions f1 and f2 we defined before. Note that we also need g at 0 to calculate the next p, and p at 0 to calculate g. Splitting the vectors gives you this equation. And using the definition of the vector functions f and x, the equation even further simplifies. But wait! This equation looks a lot like the first step of Euler's method for the function y. Isn't that convenient? This equation is the first step of Euler's method for systems of differential equations. If you would do another step to calculate x at 2 times delta t, you get an equation like this. You can repeat this process, which would give you the general step of Euler's method for systems. The value of x after n plus 1 time steps of size delta t is approximately equal to x after n steps of delta t plus delta t times the value of the right-hand side function after n steps of delta t. If you perform a few steps yourself, you obtain a list of approximations of the vector function x at several consecutive times, all delta t apart. Now it is time for you to program Euler's method for systems yourself and approximate the solutions to a system of differential equations.